We would see the sun over there at the base of the top. It's 8:15, so again, if it was clear, it would be about 5 minutes before the sun would appear just over the rooftops at the base of the tower. So we were just hoping for a flash of sunlight, so a clearing in the clouds. Oh, there was a flash on top of the tower. Okay. So I'm sure many of you have been here before and seen this wonderful event, but again, on a clear day, the sun rises at the base of the tower, and then it rolls up the side of the tower from here. And at about 9 o'clock, it finally breaks free of the summit of the tower and appears over the tower. Wonderful sight. However, we are here today, winter solstice, to honour a special event. An event that only happens once every 26,000 years. The great year. And at that time, at this time, the Earth, the winter solstice sun, are aligned to the center of the galaxy. And this site, this mound, built here to observe the winter solstice, this sun, is in alignment with that event. So we come here in the footsteps of our ancestors, those who built this mound, we don't know when, but thousands of years ago, to align ourselves to this event. In one tradition, the conventional tradition, the great year is measured by the zodiac and the movement from one house of the zodiac to the other. And according to convention, we are now moving from the sign of Pisces into the sign of Aquarius. Which sounds like a good thing. However, that is not the only way to measure the cycle of the great year. This 26,000 year cycle, of which Pisces and Aquarius are simply one age. There are other ways to mark the great year. And this moment, when the winter solstice sun passes over the galaxy at its center, seems to have been observed by other ancient traditional peoples as the turning point. The 12 o'clock in the great year, the midnight moment, the new year moment, if you like, the moment when everything comes to an end and the new eon begins. So what we're doing today is that we are setting up a gateway on this alignment and inviting you to step through that gateway to signal your willingness to make this change. This is the moment when everything changes. we were born in this era to step through this gateway to acknowledge and make this change. Did you think you were here for anything else? So, in the center of the circle, there's some sesame seeds and some incense. And you are invited to come to the center of the circle, make a blessing, offer the seeds to the fire, and then, with an open heart and a prayer for the new, to walk through the gateway into the new eon. Okay?
Okay.
Right. So, let's set up the circle. And just...
do it.
This to the dedicated to the fire. This symbolizes the arrow of the archer, Sagittarius, moving from Sagittarius into Scorpio. And this will prepare the portal.
Bring the milk and the honey, the milk of the mother, the honey of the bee, the sweetness, the juiciness of life. Together we bring the union and the presence of ourselves through the arches into the new. I bless this earth. Sweetness of the milk and the honey. I bless this earth, the sweetness of the milk. And I bless this ground of our ancestors, as we look towards the rising sun, with hope and gladness and love in our hearts, as we step through the portal. Fully present, fully alert, fully awake to take in the news.